Welcome everyone to Learning 28 Days. For this motivational webinar, My Journey from MVV Subramaniam, our guest speaker. Mr. Subramaniam belongs to a remote village called Nelatooru in East Godavari district, Andhra Pradesh. He did his schooling in Nelatooru in government school from 1st to 10th standard in Telugu medium. Later, he shifted to Tanuku to do his diploma in electrical engineering. Okay, here he faced the difficulty because there is a change in medium from Telugu to English. Then he did his graduation, that is BTech in electrical engineering, from Andhra University campus, Knight College. It is not a regular college, but it is a Knight College for 4 years. He appeared for GATE 2006 and secured an All India rank of 90. Then he chose to do post graduation in IIT Kharagpur in electrical engineering. Okay, during his campus interview, he got selected to electrical core company Osram. Osram is a company that mainly deals with electrical luminaries. Then at this juncture, he thought his aspirations are different, and he shifted his domain from pure electrical, from core electrical engineering, to software industry. At this point, he doesn't know ABCs of computer science engineering. Only he did coding in his final year project, that too in MATLAB, for his M.Tech thesis. Okay, so it takes a lot of courage after studying one discipline for 24 years. Then you start completely new at the age of 24. He joined a company called Huawei for a package of 3.5 lakhs per annum, which is less than what Osram was offering. And then he gradually accepted the challenges, changed himself according to the requirement of the industry, and he grew. Right now he's working in Microsoft as a senior software engineer, drawing a salary of 3 crore per annum. We are not quantifying the success in terms of the salary or the emoluments he's getting, but here we want to glorify his struggle, his willpower, his ambitiousness to achieve big. Okay, most of us would have stopped with a core job and we would have continued it. But he thought big, he dreamt big, and his aspirations were big, and he was ready to accept the change. He was ready to accept the transition from one domain to a completely new domain. Let us hear more from the man himself. So I welcome MVV Subramaniam for this webinar.
Hi guys. Thanks for giving me the opportunity to share my journey with you, and what shaped me here, where I am, what are my experiences I went through, what are the key learnings of my life, I wanted to share with you. I hope that will help you guys reach good career goals in your life as well. So without wasting much time, let me jump into a few of my learnings over the years, what helped me to shape where I am, what I am today. So, born in a very remote village. So I have, did my schooling in Telugu medium, and I'm very normal guy. I'm not really very very bright student. I don't even have a bigger goals, bigger dreams. I don't even know what does it mean to study engineering. For that matter, after 1960, no one in our village has even done a diploma. So that kind of a remote village I am in, and yeah, I don't even know like I can do engineering. I don't even have that kind of dream or aspirations. But yeah, something changed, and few of my teachers felt that I'm good at science and mathematics, suggested me write diploma. I followed their suggestion, and after that I realized there's much out there which we can explore, and much we can achieve in the life. So while doing so, as anything else in life, nothing comes for free. Nothing comes easy. Everything you have to go through. Learnings, basically, you have to constantly drive yourself towards bigger goals, bigger ambitions. And those are I want to share some of my learnings which helped me to constantly pursue bigger ambitions and bigger goals in my life. So, yeah, without wasting much time, let me drop into those things and I will share with you. Hopefully, this will help you as well. Yeah, I want to talk about, like, you know, first and foremost quality that any person must exhibit to be able to successful in life. So the first and foremost quality is, like, you know, confidence, self-confidence. So you need to possess a confidence. If you are not confident, you cannot achieve anything. It's as simple as that. Like, you know, if you are not believing yourself, how can anyone else trust you? You should trust yourself. So then how does confidence come? Does confidence come like a magic? No. Confidence doesn't come like magic. It comes with a persistent hard work, persistent acquiring knowledge, persistent. You need to constantly, you know, do good at what you are. Then the confidence over the time it builds. So I want to share an example of mine where I was like a very, you know, shy guy. I was like initially when I was like in my 8th grade, I was like very shy. I used to be very shy to, especially, you know, mathematics is very, very scary subject for me. That time of my life, there is one of my, you know, very, very beloved teacher of mine who changed my life. He gave me the confidence saying that, hey, Subbu, you can do good. You are really having all it takes to do right way the mathematics. He gave me the confidence and that helped me to build the confidence automatically. I started focusing on more and more mathematics and science. Then eventually, you know, it resulted in a better goals, better confidence levels of mine. So everything starts small. So you have to build on top of it. As you build on your strengths more and more, it will make you more and more confident. Then this confidence gives you it will make you dream bigger, basically. Then you can go higher levels and you can have bigger and bigger passion. So, and second most important quality I felt, that constantly helped me is desire. So confidence without any, you know, core passion or desire is not of any use. So if you don't have any desire, so you will be like as it is today. So you need to have burning desire, I would say. You would have to have burning desire. That's when you will really push yourself to achieve what you want to. When you do not have any desire, so you will not do anything great. You will not do anything challenging, you will not think what is next and all. So when you have a strong desire, the desire creates a motivation in you and it makes you, you know, grow towards the direction you want to grow. So when you have a strong desire, it creates a dedication and direction. When you have desire with dedication and direction, I don't think you cannot achieve anything that you want to. All it takes is like effort. And next most important characteristics I feel is like you have to dream very big. If you don't dream, you cannot really think outside of the box and you cannot really achieve bigger things in your life. So I want to give an example of my life here. You know, when I'm just out of my village, I joined, like, you know, Tanuku Polytechnic, like Rafi was mentioning. So where I was like having to deal with the transition of from Telugu medium to English medium. So at that point of time, I have happened to come across in contact with many people who have achieved very, very good things in their life. So that time I have met one of our senior who is just today IAS officer in AP. And I have met few people who are IPS officers, who are just my college seniors. And I have met people who are like IRS, IPS. And I have met many people who are like in a very, very big positions in life. So all those things inspired dreams in my, and they provoked me dream big. And after that, I started following, you know, many other things like I follow people like Bill Gates. I really, really admire Bill Gates. So what if Bill Gates wouldn't have dreamt? Like he thought like every person in an entire world have to have a computer in his home. So if he hasn't had a dream, so maybe what we are having nowadays, this complete revolution of, you know, many things, right? Tech, nothing is there. So you should basically have courage to dream big. When you really have that courage, then you will be able to have bigger goals. The bigger goals make you have higher desire and push for results. That's where you will really, really move forward in your life. So you should have a bigger dream. When you have a dream big, then you will do bigger goals. So second, another important thing is like, you know, not having dream is one thing, and being able to have a long-term goal. So once you have a dream, you will really think, hey, what is my goal? So how am I going to achieve my dream? So what are my baby steps towards achieving the goal? So if you don't have a goal, dream is, you know, this is what you want to do. But goal is like, you know, in achieving your dream, you're setting milestones. While these milestones will serve you a dot towards reaching your final goal. So when you have this goal sets you direction. So this goal is really, you should have a goal such that it aligns to your long-term objectives. That way, when you have this kind of goal, it will set you direction, and you can build short-term goals. On top of the short-term goals, you can execute upon. While the short-term goals are aligning to your long-term goal, you continuously make progress without being lost. So I want to share an example of mine, my personal journey here. So when I've been like in my diploma, like I've been inspired by the other people whom I came in touch with, like my seniors who are like IAS, IPS officers. So who are my just alumni. So they came to our college and they shared their learnings to me. So that inspired me to have a bigger goal and dreams. So that's when I realized, okay, I want to pursue my master's in IIT. So this oath I made in year of 2000, and I joined IIT in 2006. So think about it. So I have dreamt about it 6 years before. And what is the best possible way to reach the goal? Given I am in polytechnic, there is no direct way to reach to IIT. So I cannot reach. I do not have an option to write JEE because for polytechnic students, it's not allowed. So then I searched for opportunities. How can I reach my goal? Then I found like, okay, let me just do polytechnic to part-time engineering and utilize all the time available to acquire knowledge. And then finally move on to IIT is what my dream. So I conceived this goal and I have built short-term checkposts in between, and I constantly executed upon each of the checkpost, and then I finally reached my goal of entering IIT in 2006. So really having a long-term goal makes you not being lost. While, I mean, if you do not have a long-term goal, basically you will lose. You will lose track. So when you have really long-term goal, you can always build short-term goals which aligns with your long-term goal. Then you can constantly march towards your short-term goal. So when you really reach each of your short-term goal, you will always reach your long-term goal the way you are expecting it. So another important thing that shaped me what I am today, and that basically helped me to take a better and wise decisions in my life, is like I always prioritized and given importance to long-term success than short-term failures or short-term troubles. So this is where, like, after I have completed my engineering and I have seen, like, a lot of other possibilities, like booming industries are there in IT. And I really been passionate about, like, the growth of information technology and computer science, the rate at which it's going. And I really, like, felt like, yeah. So at that point, I had really spent a good enough number of years in learning electrical engineering. But I was also being passionate and slowly developed some kind of love towards computer science. As part of my M.Tech, I was, like, doing some courses which are like artificial intelligence, data sciences, algorithms. So those are all, like, really fascinated me, and I felt like, okay, I want to pursue that. But if I want to pursue that, but I don't have any knowledge, so I'm not really very good at any of these things, there will be definitely short-term hurdles. But none of these things really discouraged me. I always, like, felt like, okay, that's fine. So at beginning of my first year in my diploma, I didn't worry about, like, I don't know Telugu to English translation, how it will work out. I took that chance and I did whatever it takes to be successful there. So that confidence gave me, like, okay, let's take this path. So same way, like, when I took this path, yeah, it is not easy. It is really tough. I went through multiple failures, but I never ever retreated or regret, because I know that I chose the right path. And I continued pursuing the path I took. And over a period of time, it really stood out that my decision of giving importance to long-term success is always a good thing. And I was able to reach to heights that feel like I wouldn't have been able to reach if I didn't make this decision in my life. So another thing phenomenal to your success would be is, if you don't love what you do, you will not be able to be successful. So you have to love what you're doing, or you do what you're loving. So in either case, loving is common. And as a student, I feel like you should love what you're doing. So as a student, you are studying. So you should love every minute of studying. So you should do really, really good at studies. That's when that gives you the confidence that it takes to be facing the real world and successful there. So once you reach the real world, you should love your job. When you love your job, you will really, really do well. When you do well, no one can really beat you. Passion for excellence, right? So this is another important thing anyone must possess. So it's not just that you really do good. So when you really aim for excellence, so everyone else in the path to you are no competition. Basically, you will outweigh everybody in the path of yours, and you stand out. So when you really give, are really passionate about excellence, not just results. So you should really aim for excellence, not like just getting marks or just getting results. So when you really passionate about excellence, that's when you will really, really stand out everywhere. So I definitely feel this is one of my core characteristics that helped me growing faster in my ladder, or growing at a good pace in my life. Never give up. So like I told you, when you have chosen any career path, you will face hurdles, you will face challenges, you will face troubles. And when you face these troubles or any kind of challenges, if you give up, so then there is no chance that you will be successful, or you will basically reach the bigger, bold ambitions that you set for yourself. So, I mean, I just want to give an example, like, how many scientists we know, right? Many, many scientists are there. So do you think all these scientists are people who are like successful today have achieved their results or dreams in first attempt? No, they will not. So if they give up on their attempts, so they will never be able to successful. If they are not successful, so we wouldn't have had so much of technology or so many of things that we are having today, like airplane, mobile, or anything that for that matter, right? Any of the technology that you are using today, many of which wouldn't have been possible. So like that, similarly, I also faced many challenges, like when I stepped away from electrical engineering and I took the path of computer science. So I basically had faced many challenges. I was like not knowing anything, and I was like having troubles in understanding the computer science subjects, concepts, work, but I didn't give up. All I did is put more efforts, and the moment it takes, I mean, see, you never give up. Giving up should be our last thing to do. If you want to be successful, giving up thing should be your last thing in our life to do. When you don't give up, eventually you will reach successful milestones in your life. Learn from failures. So this is another important thing. So most of us might have already heard and know, but it's really tough to put it in practice. When you really put this one into practice, it makes wonders. It creates wonders. So I want to share an example of mine. Like it revolves around my transition from electrical engineering to computer science. So I joined an IT company, Huawei, at my after my graduation from IIT. So where I struggled to be successful. So that's when I realized I want to move on. I want to go to something else, somewhere else. Then I have given a couple of interviews and I miserably failed. So when I failed miserably, so I felt like, okay, let me step back. Let's see, why am I failing? What is the problem? What it takes to be successful? I don't have it. So then I looked back and then I realized that what I don't have, it takes to be successful. Then I spent a year of time in acquiring all the knowledge that it requires to be successful. And then I was like able to crack another MNC interview, which is far better than the current company, with a double salary. And so if I wouldn't have stepped back, if I wouldn't have learned from my mistakes, it wouldn't have possible. If I would have said, hey, these interviews are like crap. These interviews are nothing. These guys are like that only. They ask only impossible questions. If I would have thought in that way, that me being able to get 100% change in my salary and being able to reach another MNC, which is far better than the current one I am in, which wouldn't been impossible. So definitely you should always look back, learn from your mistakes. When you learn from your mistakes, you will realize what you can correct yourself, and that will make you really, really successful, and it will make you step towards right things in your life. Yeah, another thing is like you should learn to handle failures. So how many of you think like there will not be any failure in life? Do you think anyone will be able to achieve what they are in their life without having to face any failures? Do you think?
No, failures are imminent. They are bound to happen.
Yeah. So when failure comes, so the key difference I definitely feel, if a successful person and a person who cannot handle failure, is the way he handles the failure. If you are not able to handle the failure, you will not be able to take bigger challenges, bigger goals. You cannot reach higher heights, because failure teaches you lessons. Failure teaches you experience. It gives you experience. It teaches you techniques to approach difficult problems. So failures is imminent way of getting creative. If you do not know how to face a failure, you cannot really know how can you achieve higher heights in your life. So every person should master how to handle failures. So when you get a failure, you should really have someone who really believes in you, who gives you enough, you know, support, or, you know, that's how you, you do whatever it takes to be able to get in control of the failure. And eventually you step onto the failure. You don't get onto, failure should not control you. You should control the failure. That's how you will basically move on your life and reach really higher heights. And I want to add on top of this, like for any person in life, I strongly believe life or success is not really a destination. And this you might have heard 100 times, 1,000 times, but this is like universal truth. You should never feel compassionate about your success. When you feel like satisfied with your success or results, that's when your growth ends. So you should always be eager to achieve more. You should always treat success as a journey. You should internalize it to the best you can. When you really, really feel success is a journey and believe and internalize and live with that fact, that's when you can constantly achieve success after success, and that will lead to you being able to reach higher heights in your life. So with that, I would hand over to Rafi. Thanks for giving this an opportunity to talk for all the young minds. Hopefully this will inspire a few people and they will be able to reach good career positions in their lives too.
Yeah, just I want to put forward a few questions on behalf of Learning 28 Days. The first question is, you have done the post-graduation and you have done all your graduation in electrical engineering for 9 years. Usually a BTEC graduate does it for only 4 years. Suppose a PG graduate does it for 6 years. You have even done the diploma in electrical engineering for 3 more years. So you have a vast knowledge and vast experience in electrical field. The first question which I want to ask you, do you feel that the electric field is useless or not lucrative, that's why you want to get transition yourselves to computer science? That's my first question, Mr. Subbu.
Yeah, it's nothing like that. So like I told you, right? So it's like a journey for me. So the day I began my life from stepped away from my village, so it was always a journey for me. So the path taught me many things. So during this journey, times I happened to realize some things are like more fascinating to me, and I wanted to explore those things. So I was like really awed by the, you know, opportunities possible and the amount of, you know, learning, innovation happening in this field. And that's, I really fell in love with the technology space. That's the reason I chose in the path. I want to be in the technology space. It's not that electrical engineering is not really the path forward or anything. So it's like, that's what made me felt like I was like really loved seeing the amount of things that are changing in this space. That's when I felt, okay, let me see this. And that's where I jumped onto it.
The second thing being, how did this learning of machines, power system, power electronics, all the electrical stuff, did they help all this learning process of electrical engineering? Did it help you in any way in facing the lot of transitions and challenges which you have gone through in your life? Because I could see that it takes a lot of courage at the age of 24 to completely change your domain and start from the beginning, start from ABC off into a completely different domain. So what this 9 years of electrical engineering has given to you, and what qualities it has built up, and what analytical skills it has given so that you can undergo so many transitions and achieve such big things at a smaller age?
So like I told you, right? See, when you be really this electrical engineering, like at the core, anything is like, you know, electrical computer science, everything is like engineering, and it takes the same kind of mindset. It takes the same kind of thinking. So my 9 years of education really gave me that kind of insightful thinking, and it gave me the courage that I can achieve anything in my life. So it gave me the confidence that I can do anything in the life. And, you know, for that matter, computer science compared to electrical engineering is like, I would say, far easier in understanding the concepts. That I would say, like, it gave me the confidence that, hey, I'm able to learn this really toughest subject in the life. So why not I'll be able to learn computer science? So that's not a big challenge for me, because I was able to do this and I was able to nail it.
Thank you, Subbu. One last thing which I want to ask you is, what suggestion you want to give, or what one thing which you want to tell to all our young electrical engineering graduates or any other graduates? So what one quality or what one thing should they possess to achieve their dreams?
So I'm sincere, you know, I definitely feel, you know, youth really, really have a lot of potential. And just that they are not putting it to the right use. And I definitely feel everybody should really, really dream big and have courage to dream big and do everything that it takes to really realize their dreams. So when you dream big and you put 100% of your efforts to realize your dreams, I don't think anything is impossible. World has platforms, so many platforms, and that you can take upon and build your success story at one. Like, I can give n number of examples. So for that matter, you see Elon Musk. So he is just born in South Africa, and today you see he made out basically NASA, basically entire United States, he made proud of because of his entrepreneurship skills. So it's not been, it wouldn't have been possible if he has not dreamt. So for that matter, Steve Jobs, so Bill Gates, so Abdul Kalam. So all these things, these are all really, these guys are like, they were able to dream big and have faith in their self, and they were able to consistently invest what it takes to be successful in the life. That's when they were able to achieve. And there is no miracle to success. All it takes is persistence, perseverance, patience. So dream big, make right moves towards your success story. Your story you can only build. No one else can build it. So you have to really put your cornerstones for your story. So that's my advice to everybody.
The last thing is, on what project you are currently working in Microsoft? Can you throw some light on what exactly you're doing in there?
So right now I work in Azure Data. So this is like, you know, it's like fascinating. It's like fascinating field to be in. So you guys know really, like, you know, how much data we are creating daily. Photos, videos, WhatsApp, messages, COVID, how is it transiting, from where, how? So supply chain, like, you see, right? So Amazon is a company, it needs to deal with the problems like, hey, so what kind of product is being sold in South India, Hyderabad most? And where should my fulfillment centers be? Where should my supply chain be? And how should I optimize the logistics? So all these kind of insights, it's really, really requires a deep analysis. So I'm working on a service, a technology which helps organizations to be able to build this kind of expertise, you know. So you can use petabytes or terabytes of data, and you can extract insights out of it. You can learn saying, hey, COVID cases are spreading more here. And this is being spread by because of this person. So you can have millions of data points. All those data points you can correlate, create visualizations. And so this technology is being used in medical field to extract data samples about blood results, how a vaccine is effectively working on people. So we work with Azure. Azure is like we say, right? It's a world computer. So we enable technologies around the world. So we are enabling US government. We are enabling US military. We are enabling China. We are enabling health organizations to across the world in dealing with the COVID research cases. This is really a fascinating field to be in.
Thank you very much, Sipu, from all of our 28 days learning 28 days team. We thank very much for your time and effort in giving the insights and gentlemen, I'll give the opportunity. So I request some of our participants to ask a few questions if they have. Yes, gentlemen, you can unmute and you can ask. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Sir, my question is that, sir, you have done your journey from very small village to Microsoft. And you have achieved many things in your life, and now you are a successful person, sir. And we know that success doesn't come very easily. It cost many sacrifices and many failures. So you have beautifully explained your success story, sir. So my question is to you, sir: how do you take the failures in your life? I mean, sir, what are the lessons that one should take from the failures?
Yeah, this is a very wonderful question. So, you know, like I told you, right? So, no person is exempt from failures. So, for that matter, I am not too. So, I don't know. If any person says that he has achieved success without being undergoing failures, I really, really, so maybe he might be able to achieve till that point in life, but it's not constantly possible. So similarly, I also went through failures, multiple failures. So I would say like, I have many failures in my life. When I stepped down, when I graduated from the IIT and I took up on my first job in Huawei. So I don't even know what is a software, you know, I don't see, for that matter, I never even programmed in C++. So I am having to deal with thousands of lines of code in C++. And I really didn't understand anything. I was not able to understand. I was not able to cope up with others. So I was like a lagger in my complete team. But so if you are being lagged, so that's where my skill of 9 years experience, where I learned whatever the skills I learned in my 9 years of education, right? So what it takes to be successful, right? So you basically drive, you don't give up. You never give up. If you give up, you are lost. Do you want to be lost? So if you are like thrown into a river, right? So will you fight until you live, or you give up saying that, hey, I'm tired. You will not give up, right? Until you are dead, right?
Yes, sir.
So that's what it takes to be successful. So I never gave up. So I said like, okay, that's okay. So failures are imminent in the life. So I used to go to office and come back home. Every day I used to take one subject of computer science. I used to go to work from 9 to 9. So because that's a very intensive job. I used to work in Huawei. So if you ask anybody, Huawei is like hell. So they take, they drain you basically. But still, I used to come after home at 9, finish my dinner, and I used to sit till 1 a.m. I used to read all the computer science subjects. Because I used to analyze myself, hey, I'm not able to do good here. Why am I not able to do good? Because I don't know that. So what it takes to be knowing that? Just a matter of reading. Just a matter of investing time.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Anyone else who want to ask the question? Don't hesitate, gentlemen, because every day this opportunity doesn't come. all these qualities which Subbu have told are not alien to everyone. We know all of them. But he man who has put everything, has accepted every challenge, who has put everything into practice. Okay, gentlemen. So again, I thank Subramanian for his time, for his effort in preparing this presentation and everything. Thank you very much, Subbu. I hope this effort which you have kept will be helpful, at least for a few students who will learn the lessons from you.
Thank you for giving this opportunity to share my learnings with really bright minds here. And hopefully my journey inspires someone in this group. Like a few of my seniors' journey inspired me. So I hope at least if one of these people are like really being inspired and really want to take their career in their control. So I would feel like this is like a great success to the our effort, I feel. Yeah, thank you everybody. Hopefully you guys will become really an icon of success in your next few years. I wish you all the best for your career aspirations.
Thank you all participants. That's it for today. Thanks for
thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Have a good day.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye bye.